three-dimensional coordinate systems, level 2. In the previous video, we reviewed the basics of one-dimensional, two-dimensional, and three-dimensional coordinate systems. In this video, we will begin representing basic equations in three-dimensional space. Before we dive in with equations, we need to be able to draw a three-dimensional coordinate system and be able to identify and navigate through all its parts without getting lost. Let's first start with a traditional two-dimensional Cartesian coordinate system. Recall that this coordinate system is formed by two axes, the x-axis and the y-axis, which are perpendicular to each other. In addition, this coordinate system is divided into four quadrants. The first quadrant is located here. Then we move counterclockwise to label the second, third, and fourth quadrant. Recall that each quadrant determines the signs on the x and y coordinate of a point. You can view the previous video with a more in-depth look on two-dimensional coordinate systems. For now, I want you to keep in mind that a two-dimensional coordinate system represents a plane. Now, when we draw a three-dimensional coordinate system, we usually draw the standard placement of the axis, meaning we only show the positive axis for each variable, and we extend the lines for each axis when needed. So we first draw the positive z and y axis as follows. Then we extend the x axis from the common point of intersection of the z and y axis as follows. This is the standard position of a three-dimensional coordinate system. Keep in mind that we will tend to extend the lines for each axis when needed. Also, keep in mind that all the physical drawings you make are done in a two-dimensional sheet of paper. This means that you will have to use your spatial visualization skills to see most of these three-dimensional graphs. But in these videos, I will create actual three-dimensional images so you can start getting an intuition of how these graphs are truly represented. Let's take a look at our two-dimensional coordinate system. It turns out that this coordinate system represents the xy coordinate plane in a three-dimensional coordinate system, as shown on the right. If you view the plane from above, it's actually turned a little over 90 degrees clockwise. This means that the first quadrant is located here, the second quadrant here, the third quadrant in the back, and the fourth quadrant is located here. You really need to wrap your head around this and be able to view the xy plane in a three-dimensional system. This way, you can translate all of your understanding of a two-dimensional coordinate system into the xy plane of a three-dimensional coordinate system. In addition, keep in mind that there are two other planes, the yz plane and xz plane. If you understand how graphs behave in the xy plane, you will easily understand how graphs behave in the yz and xz plane. It's pretty much the same concept. Alright, now let's actually start graphing equations. Recall from your studies of algebra that a graph in two-dimensional analytical geometry, in other words, in the Cartesian coordinate plane, involving the variables x and y, is represented by a curve in R squared. For example, the equation y equals 3 represents the following set, which is a set of all points, also known as ordered pairs, in R squared whose y coordinate is 3. This means that this equation contains all the points whose coordinate is x3. The way we represent this is by plotting all the points in the xy plane, or in this case, R squared, whose y coordinate is 3. Doing that, we would obtain the following points. Notice that every single point has 3 as its y coordinate. Now, this set of ordered pairs is in theory infinite, so instead of plotting all the possible points, we usually represent all these infinite points by connecting them with a curve, as follows. In this case, we have a horizontal straight curve connecting all the points that are generated by the given equation. In addition, this line is also parallel to the x-axis and perpendicular to the y-axis. In the same manner, the equation x equals 3 represents the following set, which is a set of all points whose x-coordinate is 3. This means that this equation contains all the points whose coordinate is 3y. The way we represent this is by plotting all the points in the xy plane whose x-coordinate is 3. Doing that, we would obtain the following points. Notice that every single point has 3 as its x-coordinate. Once again, we usually represent all these infinite points by connecting them with a curve, as follows. In this case, we have a vertical straight curve connecting all the points that are generated by the given equation. In addition, this line is also parallel to the y-axis and perpendicular to the x-axis. Notice that when you have an equation with a single variable, such as y equals 3 or x equals 3, the second variable is free to take any value, since there were no restrictions on that variable. This idea will be very important when we start graphing equations in a three-dimensional coordinate system. So let's go ahead and graph the equation y equals 3 in R cubed. Notice that from this point on, it's key to specify what coordinate system we are referring to. Is it R squared or R cubed? Since this will determine how many variables we're going to deal with, and ultimately determine the final graph of the equation. In this case, we are graphing y equals 3 in R cubed. This equation represents the following set, which is a set of all points, also known as ordered triples, in R cubed, whose y coordinate is 3. This means that this equation contains all points whose coordinate is x, 3, z. So we first draw the curve for the equation y equals 3 in the xy plane as follows. This curve is analogous to the curve in R squared, but now we're graphing it in R cubed. This line represents all the points whose coordinate is x, 3, 0. But remember that the equation y equals 3 does not contain any of the other two variables, x or z. This means that these variables are free to take any values. As a consequence, the following points are also part of the set of the equation y equals 3 in R cubed. These points represent the various values which include the z coordinate. So all these points are also points that are generated by the equation y equals 3. Once again, in theory, we have an infinite number of points, so we usually connect all these points with a surface. In this case, the equation is represented by a plane. It's essentially a sheet of paper that is parallel to the xz plane, and is also perpendicular to the y-axis. In the same way, the equation x equals 3 is represented in R cubed as follows. It's also a plane that is parallel to the yz plane, and is perpendicular to the x-axis. Finally, the equation z equals 3 will be represented as follows. It's also a plane that is parallel to the xy plane and perpendicular to the z-axis. At this point, we have equations to describe the coordinate planes of a three-dimensional coordinate system. The xy plane can be represented by the equation z equals 0. The xz plane is represented by the equation y equals 0. And a yz plane is represented by the equation x equals 0. Alright, another concept that requires an understanding of these coordinate planes is the idea of a projection of an object on one of these planes. Let's keep it simple and first talk about the projection of a point on the coordinate planes. Say we have a random point in space, let's call it point P, whose coordinates is equal to x, y, and z. If I were to view this point from above, and shine a light directly above this point, it will create a shadow that is located in the xy plane, directly below point P. The location of this shadow in the xy plane is called the projection of P on the xy plane. This point has the same x and y coordinates as point P, but has a z coordinate of 0. Remember, the equation of the xy plane is represented by the equation z equals 0. So any point on that plane will have a z coordinate of 0. So let's denote the projection of P on the xy plane as point Q. It will have coordinates equal to x, y, and 0. Now, if I were to look at point P from the first octant, facing towards the yz plane, and I shine a light at point P, it will cast a shadow directly across point P. This is a projection of P on the yz plane, and has the same y and z coordinates as point P, but has an x coordinate of 0. The equation of the yz plane is represented by the equation x equals 0. So every point on this plane has 0 as its x coordinate. Let's denote the projection of P on the yz plane as point R, and it will have coordinates equal to 0, y, and z. Lastly, if I were to look at point P from the first octant facing towards the xz plane, and I shine a light at point P, it will cast a shadow directly across point P. This is the projection of point P on the xz plane, and has the same x and z coordinates as point P, but has a y coordinate of 0. The equation of the xz plane is represented by the equation y equals 0. So every point on this plane has 0 as its y coordinate. Let's denote the projection of P on the xz plane as point S, and it will have coordinates equal to x, 0, and z. In a later topic, this concept of a projection is going to be useful as we tackle more challenging concepts in multivariable calculus. Alright, in the next video, we will continue representing basic equations in three-dimensional space.